Generals, gentlemen.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Company of Heroes Singular. Indeed, we are in Co. 1, or Tales of Valor, casting something a little bit different.
I'm excited. I'm personally excited. I didn't play a lot of Co. 1, so I think it's going to be cool to be getting into it, doing my best shot of trying to work out what units are and how the game is different from Co. 2. We're on Lungras, aren't we?
Yeah, this is Lungras, alright. Yeah, so basically, cool. There's probably going to be a lot of explaining to Blake how things work. So if you're a super Gosu top tier Co. 1 player, you might be a little bit frustrated at how basic level this is. This is kind of being aimed at Co. 2 players, I guess. But hey, I'll try and give them metas. And speaking of metas, this is a really weird build here from Pershalicious. He's actually gone triple Engie.
Yeah, don't you normally go like lots of Riflemen?
Yeah, Riflemen are pretty good.
Why are there three Engies? That's different.
Yeah, so Pershalicious is our American at the top here. Who do we have at the bottom?
That's going to be Woggle. He's going to be playing down here as our Wehrmacht. Fantastic.
Indeed. So, Lungras Kaya, not Lungras. It's French.
Yeah.
Basically, Lungras. Because like all the Co. 1 maps are France, whereas Co. 2 is Russian, so they add on Kaya and Oski onto the ends of things.
For fun.
Just because why not? So there is our barracks, triple engine. I think it's actually a bug in our replay. Yeah, there you go.
Okay, yep. Fixed.
So capping that one down.
It's
so
interesting. Going for
actually,
what's up with the forward munitions cap?
I don't know. I think he wants to deny it more than anything else. I mean,
okay.
Munitions is actually really important for Wehrmacht in Co. 1. There's a lot of like abilities and upgrades. It's kind of similar to Co. 2, where Wehrmacht really want the munitions, but there's a lot of different things you can do with it. So I don't necessarily think going for that munitions point was exactly a best idea. But anyway, at the bottom here, we do have two Pyos, and now the Volkskren's coming out. That's very, very standard for Wehrmacht play. Almost losing the Engineer. You can actually evac out of the... Actually, can you? There's no door there.
The door's on the sides.
I'm pretty sure in Kotu there's a door there.
Yeah, I think so. I'm pretty sure you can evac off to the side of that building.
Yeah.
It's flatter as well. Like, it's the same general idea for the garrison, but... I mean, the Engineer's still capping, which is going to be nice. I mean, there is a lot of cap power here with, I mean, three Engineers.
Yeah, but the thing is, that's interesting about going Engies. It's actually not as cap-heavy as you would expect, because Riflemen actually have a 1.5 capping speed.
Ah.
So what that means is Riflemen literally cap 1.5 times faster than pretty much every other unit in the game. So Engies aren't actually the best at capping. It will give them a lot of repairs. So sometimes you see, like, three Engies followed up by a Jeep, so you can just mass repair. Volkskreneers are coming down to deal with the Engineers. Engineers and Pyos, they're actually pretty similar despite the three-man squad. Engies generally are better though, but definitely we'll even that one out with the Volkskreneers. Riflemen moving down as well. And just as the point is finally captured back, the Riflemen will decap that. So their decapping speed is also 1.5.
Yeah, so that's cool. Really big munitions and I coming out here. Which is, you know, I think quite cool here for... Is it Pewtericious or Pershalicious?
Yeah.
Pershalicious.
The thing that makes me cry about Co. 1 is you don't have that, like, the top of the screen thing. You sort of have this, but you have to hover over it. Wow, four NGs. This is really strange.
This is cool from Pershalicious.
Yeah. So we'll have to see how it pays off, because it does definitely limit your engaging power. MG42 will start to suppress those rifle, and actually holding onto the munitions points. That's very nice to see. In the garrison, there is the Pioneers around, so... The map is pretty even thus far. Not a lot of territory onto either player. Pretty even for the most part. And I just don't think the 4 Engie will really pay off. Unless he starts to spam Flamers. Engie spam, you see it sometimes against Panzer Elite. But against Wehrmacht, it's strange. We see the first Flamer coming out now. And we may see more following it up.
It could be cool there. The Volkskrens will be getting behind the heavy cover. Trying to duel away with those Riflemen. Second Riflemen squad has come out. This is just a massive infantry bomb moving down here for Pershalicious.
Yeah, Volkskreneers is not very good at close, so, you know, especially against Riflemen and Engineers. We'll have to force disengage. I'm not really sure what he's backing into. There wasn't an MG nearby, and trying to engage as safe as he can. MG is actually in the garrison, and not going to try and, you know, rotate down to this fight here. Flamer will be excellent against the Volkskrens in the cover, and actually forcing the retreat straight away, and Pyo's Engineers are capping meanwhile.
Absolute cap war going on here. Decapping squad will get the decap before they're pinned.
Close. Ooh, sniper actually missed. When you retreat, there is a 50% hit chance. That's the same as Code 2. And Engineer once again being suppressed down. So really aggressive decaps here. And not really much income looking at Woggle, our Wehrmacht. Sniper is on the field. Sniper's very, very strong in Ko-1. They're not as squishy, like,
okay,
if you catch a sniper, they don't die as easily as they you would see in Ko-2, where snipers are so fragile. Especially, you know, without Ura, it's hard to catch them. And you can cloak while moving, I mean, it's insane.
So same cover, that's
yeah,
cool.
It's snipers are really, really strong in Ko-1. And actually retreating the Pioneers a little bit too late does get away from that rifle squad, but this one here moving in, so nice work. Gets the snipe straight
one
away.
Shot.
But with the MG and the sniper, it's a really good defensive position because the MG suppresses, the sniper has a long-range bleed, and the grenadiers really prevent the flanks.
And it's nice for Woggle because of how aggressively that Specialist has actually been playing. He's just moving his rifle mob forward and forward and forward, having the MG and the sniper there, heavy bleed. That's a Jeep coming out.
Yeah. So the Jeep is on the field, going to be ideal against the sniper, but got to be careful of the Panzerfaust. They don't, like, get a damage critical, where it actually slows, like in Ko-2, but it will yeah, do a lot of damage.
Yeah.
It's pretty much, like, three quarters. Going for the sniper, will he dive it? The Volskunis are there, ready and waiting, so gotta be careful. If he fires a Faust now, he may even just kill it. MG as well, doing some pretty good damage. He may even not need to find the Faust, but going past it, and backing away, actually, which is very surprising.
He
had free reign in the base. MG being forced away because it was actually it rotated down for the Jeep, so the rifleman could go in and force it off. So a lot of fuel in the bank here for Perlicious, and I'm not really sure what he's doing. Hasn't gone bars, and he hasn't gone for his tier 3. Tier 3 is where you get your Greyhound from, which is basically what you rush. You tend to rush either bars or Greyhound, generally depending on the composition. Sniper still firing away. Greyhounds are good against the snipers, but even so are bars, really, if you get the flank.
Yeah. Okay, yeah, it definitely interesting playstyle, but just incredibly aggressive. Does something the right hand side has a lot of fuel on there as well. The two fuel points, so I think both of them is definitely going to be nice. I mean, the defensive playstyle just hasn't been paying off. That Jeep just went really, really aggressive on the sniper, and Policious seems to have the answer for everything that that Woggle throws at him.
Yeah, trying to get the bunker because the med bunker, they are huge parts of the matchup because you get free squads if you get enough wounded soldiers back to your base.
Yeah,
they pick up and carry them back. You have to like manually force fire down the medics, else you get a free grenade squads. Pioneers take extra damage while repairing, so nice deny.
Nice.
Once again, that's the second time that Woggle has wanted to find the med bunker but denying it. So actually really great play from Perlicious here, and there's a triage center, so that's going to be nice to have. It does cost fuel, though, so it does delay your tech, but definitely worth it. You need the triage center.
Yeah, given how much infantry it has and how much bleed was affected onto those engineers and the riflemen previously. Good pick up there. We're getting a bit of third shot for the med bunker. See if that ends up working now, and that's a pack coming out here from Woggle.
Yeah, so it's going to be good against the Jeep, but I think the real reason why the pack's coming out rather than a Grenadier squad, for example, is because there's no bars.
Yeah.
If your opponent doesn't have bars, he is going for a Greyhound. There are a few exceptions, like if he's going nades or if he's going to go like ranges or something, but really that's pretty much it. Bars or Greyhound. And still, I don't know what actually Polichus is doing. He still has a lot of fuel in the bank. 95.
Quite a fair bit. It's been a nice flank down onto the MG though. Going to be suppressing down the cards, and that's bars, isn't it?
Yeah, that's the bars. Bring a lot of power to the fight here. And nice work as well, getting the flank around the MG. Pack, though, ready and waiting for the Jeep.
Ooh.
Won't quite get there in time, though. Pack will try and reface, but the Jeep's going to back away, playing it safe and playing it smart. And if the Flamer on the Engineers can burn that med bunker down, that will be a huge setback. Takes quite a while, but if there's two of them, they definitely can do it.
Yeah, should have a fair bit of work there, and the pack's cloaked as well. Off to the side, they're waiting for the Jeep to move back in. I think their sniper does get another shot there onto the rifleman, but Felicious, he's having fun engagements for sure. He's just playing so aggressively, and the MG is very, very low as well on health because of that med bunker. It was low. We get that reinforce.
Yeah, packs can cloak. It's a pretty big deal. They get extra damage as well, and that's kind of another reason why Vermark is such a strong defensive play, is because you don't know where the packs are, so it's hard to find the engagements. Flamers forcing out the Volksgrenadiers.
MG42 did save the med bunker though.
Yeah, and the thing is with Vermark is it's really crippling if you get like units like that where they have not a lot of HP, because the med bunker doesn't actually heal. It's only for the sake of getting more troops.
Getting more troops.
There are two ways of healing. You can use the med packs, which cost munitions, to heal your squad individually. Or you get the Kampfkrump Center, which allows you to buy Veterancy, and if you get Vet 1, you regenerate your health on your infantry, which costs fuel. and it takes a while. So it is, yeah, a pretty big deal getting that sort of bleed.
Okay, thanks for the clarification.
That's all right. But here is our supply yard. So going to go for the, probably the Greyhound. May even be a Sherman, though, considering...
At this point, he's got a lot of fuel.
A lot of fuel, and he has the bars already. So he doesn't really need the Greyhound as much. And with the pack, the Greyhound won't be as effective. So at the moment, yeah, Woggy is pretty far behind. Double pack. Wow, that's, yeah, really wanting to have the anti-vehicle. So must be expecting the Greyhound. But with that many bars on the field, it's going to be pretty hard to deal with two packs.
Yeah, grenades completed as well here for Polycius. You know, throwing them around. Quite nice.
Grenades are powerful.
Grenades are, yeah. As you were saying, yeah, I think I've seen them before. Like in a couple of our games.
Yeah, how the grenades
work
in Co. 1 is they scatter a lot. So that you can't aim them as precisely. In Code 2, they're like 100% accurate, but they have a lot more damage.
Yeah.
Those are Polycius's mines. No, one of them's Woggy's mine, so that will blow up a Jeep in one shot. Got to be careful with those mines. Actually, yeah, several mines. I like that. It's good play.
It's good.
Especially because if a Greyhound hits that in front of a pack, game over. Yeah, the nades, they are very powerful, having a lot of AoE, but you can't exactly make sure you land. So they're more blob control, or good against MGs, but against infantry can be dodged a lot easier. Sniper has got the Vet 1, so there's actually Vet 1 onto infantry and support weapons going into the mine. It's going to be deadly here.
Oh, wow.
Takes out a lot of the infantry. Pack will walk away. A nice flank, though, from the side. Rifleman with the bars and Flamer NGs here, but the other Riflemen were suppressed, so not going to be doing a lot of damage here, but still up that close, ripping through the Volskrins. May lose a squad. Another mine detonates, and the NG going to have to retreat, and that Volskrin running for his life here does get wiped, though, by the Rifle squad. Meanwhile, VP being denied. A really nice flank from Polycius.
Absolutely fantastic. He's playing this very, very well. His squads are quite low on health, though, as well. Got some nice wipes there. But did force off the pack and go for the tank depot.
Yeah, tier 4. So, probably a good choice again with two packs. I don't think he actually knows that there's a second pack, though. I think he's only actually seen the one pack. But with bars, yeah, you don't really need Greyhound that fast. Yep. Trying to decap the fuel. And meanwhile, trying to wipe this MG down. He may even do so. I guess suppressed by the MG. Probably would have wiped it if he did not do that. So, nice work here holding on to the units. Mind blowing up, only getting one pyo, not exactly ideal, and probably gonna be a Sherman. I mean, M10s, they're excellent against tanks, but when you're so far ahead, and also when you see that your opponent is vetting up his infantry and his support weapons, that costs even more fuel, and there's no really point getting an M10 unless your opponent has their own vehicles or tanks, so it will be a Sherman. Shermans are very strong.
Sherman coming out. Should be quite cool to see.
They're like T-34s that aren't bad.
Ah, fantastic. Yeah.
Sort of like Co. 2 Shermans, I guess. Anyway, so definitely on the back foot.
Yeah, map control here, definitely going to Polycius. 466 VPs against the 330 for Woggle. So he's definitely behind in the VP battle. Has been contesting the middle one a fair bit, though.
Hasn't gone any commanders yet either, or doctrine, which is interesting to see. Having defensive does give you some nice little boosts without having to have a lot of command points. Minesweeper being completed, a good move. So the sniper's actually doing pretty well there, 11 kills. And riflemen are pretty expensive.
Yeah.
Riflemen are 27 manpower, so that's not quite paying himself off, but close to it. And it does definitely help in engages because you're dropping the DPS so quickly. No Grenadiers as well, though, and you really need Grenadiers against the riflemen, especially against bars, because Volskrins just aren't as effective as a rifle, not by a long shot.
Especially when you're low on health and you don't really have that many munitions in the bank here for Woggle. So MG
will
be nice, though. I mean, he does have a nice defensive playstyle, just doesn't seem to work at the moment. MG42, we'll get the suppression, but second squad with the bars. Rifleman will be moving in right now. It does have the nades available, but the MG will be packing up.
Yeah, you can't suppress that many squads, and with all the munitions, there's just so many nades available. Will force the retreat. Pack as well, trying to hide. Hopefully he won't get revealed, because he's going to be dead if he is. Rifleman, they're getting close. Detection range is probably about here. No. Oh, he fired. Wasn't on hold fire mode. Whoopsie daisies. And they, the med bunker still is alive. Does take quite some time to destroy. You want the AT gun. AT guns are good against the bunkers. Demolition charges require a fuel unlock from the HQ, so generally not worth it, but it can be nice. Sometimes mine, for the sniper, I think.
Yeah, he didn't quite get it, though. He did cloak away just in time. Pioneer's going, Engineer's going absolute town there onto the med bunker. Does take a fair bit of damage. Is going to be focusing down those medics. Takes them a while to respawn, doesn't it?
Yeah, it's quite some time, yeah. So denying them is definitely a good move, and MG has a pretty good angle. Double sniper.
That's interesting.
Yeah, gotta be careful. The Sherman can wipe those pretty quickly, and that is a crocodile even. Wow, so
okay.
Crocodile, it's generally regarded as quite underpowered, and it kind of is, but this is a very specific comp that is quite vulnerable to the Crocodile. Crocodile is essentially a flame tank. It is good against infantry, it's good against the buildings, good against the AT guns. But the thing is the regular Shermans are also really good against infantry. The reason why the Crocodiles are hard to use is because of their short range. You have to go in very close, and the damage is very inconsistent. But the main strength of the Crocodile, as opposed to the regular Sherman, is they're very good at wiping packs. The regular Shermans, you got to be careful with around packs, but Crocodiles, they will kill them pretty quickly. And of course, not having any anti-vehicle does leave them vulnerable to any kind of tank, which isn't coming out because the little fuel that is held by Woggy is going into his veterancy. So if you vet your infantry or support weapons, you don't get vehicle, essentially, or they're delayed significantly.
300 points now for Woggle. Probably winning the VP battle. Is there a doctrine selection here from
yep.
Polish?
That's Armor Company.
Yep, okay.
He can use the field repairs, which is actually going to be very nice for the Crocodile. It's a global ability, pop it, and then your tanks repair on the field. Good if you can pop in engagement as well. So you can repair your Crocodile during an engagement. So a good move, actually. Oh, he's getting a dozer, though, which will take up the munitions and preventing him from using the repair. Now, I'm actually a bit of a MacBook noob, and I don't remember whether or not field repairs builds into the Calliope or builds into the Pershing. I'm pretty sure it's Pershing, but I could be wrong. Anyway, pack is firing now. Sherman out of the Conan will look for the med bunker. Hasn't found any Grens yet. Nice mine detonating them down, and a lot of packs are firing onto the Crocodile. He's got to be careful. He's getting pretty low. Gonna have to back away. The packs are very, very powerful, especially with the ambush bonus. Almost wipes that one down, and the two snipers are ripping through these riflemen.
Definitely working out here. This is the first engagement we've really seen Moggle win. Precise. I'm looking for a word that sounds like this. Concisely?
Win good.
He won real good this time.
Yeah.
He won real good. He not win real good previous time. He win real good this time.
Nice.
What now, Woggle?
See, I think this is also the weakness of the Crocodile, as you can see, is that you have to get in close. And
it was a good part from range.
Yeah, and by getting in close, it really leaves you in the arc of the packs, where the Sherman, you play it like a long-range sniper unit. You just sort of run around, try and get within range of infantry, because Grenadiers with four-man squads, it's a lot of bleed if you are able to blow them up.
Has a Shrek as well.
Yeah, it has a Shrek, and they're actually pretty good. 75 missions has hit Vet 2, and Vet 2 is absolutely crucial for the Wehrmacht Grenadiers because they get elite armor. Pioneers make it. Oh, just kidding, Minesweeper.
That should be absolutely fine there. Yeah, the snipers definitely are inflicting some pretty heavy bleed onto these riflemen, really are winning the engagements. Going into that, probably not the best idea.
Yeah.
Look for a nade or
not really sure.
Aggressive.
So what I was going to say is the Vet 2 on Grenadiers, it gives them elite armor and a lot of infantry as well. So what that actually means is they get, I forget the number, but they get a lot less accuracy versus small arms. So it gives them a pretty big edge against, you know, riflemen or any just sort of, MGs, like on a Sherman, for example. Won't help them against, like, explosives and against flame weapons. So it won't make them take less damage from a Crocodile, which is nice, but yeah, the Riflemen will be less effective. Volksgrenadiers don't benefit much at all. Volksgrenadiers, they get like a little bit, I think it's 5% extra health, and they get less received suppression, so it's not really worth the fuel investment for Volksgrenadiers, but if you have Grenadiers, definitely worth it. And I think that's actually two now, because he's probably got a free squad from his med bunker, maybe? Oh, that was a spray for all, I think. Yeah, that was it there. Okay, so never mind. Only having the one squad free. Hasn't actually built anything yet. Crocodile, very, very inconsistent its DPS, but it can get some lucky crits like that. There we go.
Oh, wow.
That's the Crocodile doing
so.
Wow, he may even wipe this squad. That was insane.
Yeah, quite low.
Two members, yeah. And bear in mind,
doing work.
How it works in Code 1 with Veterancy is you only get Veterancy on kills.
Yeah.
So, you don't, like, the packs aren't vetting by hitting a crocodile, they have to actually kill
it. Oh, massive flank here, I think one of the snipers actually went down.
Yeah, he
there.
Got it with a lucky rifleman burst from a bar, a huge blow, losing that sniper, and the pressure is on once again for Palicious. The MG, not in position, did have to retreat away from that flank.
There are just too many flanks coming in here from Palicious. He always has his riflemen split up really, really nicely. The bar's just flanking down the MGs. Pack is almost within vision range. Doesn't get seen, though. And it's a smaller pack, something like pack 38 or something.
No, they're 40s, I'm pretty sure.
38?
Oh, 38, okay.
38, okay, cool.
They're different to Code 2 packs, but anyway.
Yeah.
So the good thing about the bulldozer is it will allow the Sherman to, like, crush the hedge and stuff.
Okay.
So that the dozer can, the crocodile can get in a better position to burn down the med truck, firing away against the Grenadiers with a Shrek.
Shrek gonna fire, or?
Yeah, he'll fire now. Yep. Gets Vet 1, and that gives him, I believe it's extra movement speed. I'm pretty sure it's movement speed.
Yeah. We don't have an icon we can hover over like Code 2.
No, there isn't.
Makes it a bit harder.
Yeah.
The engineers are paying off now. I mean, just mass repairs onto that crocodile, which is quite nice. I mean, it has been taking quite long during the engagement. It does run straight into that MG42. They're very static pace out from Woggle. It's working. I mean, he's staying in this game, but he's losing on BPs.
Yeah, I mean, what you see, though, this is actually a pretty standard Wehrmacht play.
Okay,
like, the sort of defensive, campy play with a lot of support weapons, that's the standard. That's how Wehrmacht operates. Because the infantry just aren't good. MG actually may get wiped, though. That is the American sniper looking for the counter. No, that was a counter before. I think, yeah, that was... We missed
it. Was a counter sniper.
Yeah, it wasn't Rifleman. It must have been the sniper. Sherman, though. Gotta be careful. One thing, the pack is still there. So basically how it works with the snipers is you sort of have this sniper dance-off where you wait for your opponent to snipe, and then the moment that he snipes, you snipe him. But...
I think you showed me. I use that mechanic in Code 2. You showed me that.
So yeah, it's a lot harder in Code 1 though, because when they're moving, there's a 50% accuracy penalty, you don't always hit. So there's a bit of RNG involved, which is a bit of a problem. Other than that though, 5 command points gonna be pretty soon, and yeah, I'm pretty sure it's Pershing. But I'm probably a huge MacBook noob and probably wrong. What I would have loved to see, actually, I would have really liked to see Infantry Company be picked up for the sake of the howitzers. Howitzers will blow up the bunker, especially even just the off-map arty is very, very strong. It won't necessarily kill the bunker, but when you combine it with flamers, it pretty much will kill it. And I think that med bunker is giving too much free squads. I think it's 2 now. See, this is the dance here, where you sort of just walk around waiting for your opponent
sniper.
To reveal himself. So, can be pretty...
Are they both snipers? Is that...
That's snipers.
The third sniper built there from Woggle.
Ooh, that's a risky move here, revealing himself. But the thing is with the snipers is you actually have to be aiming preemptively. Like, you can't, like, auto-acquire.
Yeah.
Because of how quickly they re-cloak, you basically have to have your sniper selected. You have to have your, you know, your finger on the trigger... and basically hover over where you would think the sniper is, and then the moment they reveal, you click on them. You have to be really quick with it. So it's actually pretty hard to do, and you have to be waiting for it and paying attention.
Now, is that a Volscrin squad with upgrades or a new squad?
No, it's MP40s.
That's okay, yeah, the MP40s.
As you would expect, very powerful up close, very, very poor fire-on-the-move accuracy, though, which actually isn't what you would expect, given they have submachine guns, but it makes them... very powerful at close range. They can definitely 1v1 bar rifles up close, but assaulting and closing the gap, they can get gunned down if the riflemen are ready and waiting. So pushing back now and having the 2 VPs taken back, which is excellent news because he's had pretty low VPs thus far. Sherman Crocodile still rolling around here, and the problem is there's a Stug, and the Stug now... That's Stu. That's actually one of the specific commanders.
Oh, okay.
The Blitzkrieg... I think it's Blitzkrieg. Basically, it's like an ISU. I'm trying to think of the equivalent. It's a artillery piece.
We're firing away on that crocodile. We're going very, very deep here. Stug really needs to rotate. What did it fire at? Not really sure.
Rifleman, that is the Allied War Machine, so that will replace the Crocodile Sherman with a new one if it gets taken out, which it may do so. But you don't want to lose it because of the Veterancy too, but still better than losing it for nothing. So now that's interesting because Palicious hasn't gone for his call-in. The Allied War Machine and Field Repairs, they are on separate trees. There's when you pick a commander, there's left and right.
Yeah.
So he's going to delay his Pershing or his Katusha. Just kidding. It's a Calliope.
Calliope. Okay.
It's basically Katusha. It's pretty good. So I think maybe what happened there was Palicious originally was going for the Pershing, but then he realized that, no, actually, Calliope's would be way better. And absolutely, yeah, Calliope's would have been a much better choice. So I think that's going to be a bit of a blow now because, like, Armor Company is really weak in the early mid-game. Armor Company is all about the late game. Calliope's the...
Is that Jackson on the field?
That's a Hellcat.
Hellcat, okay, cool.
I don't think that's a Jackson. I'm pretty sure it's different.
Yeah.
Hellcat, it's basically an
Entei. It looks similar, so I wasn't sure.
It has stealth, though.
Yeah.
It can stealth while it's not moving. They're pretty strong. It'll definitely annihilate the Stew. The Stew, it's a call-in, and it's not very good against vehicles, but very powerful against infantry and buildings. A lot of RNG, though, like, it's a pretty inconsistent barrage weapon.
Yeah.
Short range, you can't really snipe with it, but the M10 will get very powerful against it. But the M10 has to be careful, not M10, it's a Hellcat, has to be careful against the PAX. It doesn't have a lot of HP. Here's a mine, actually, and he's within range of the double M18 Hellcats. Wow, he can lose this dude very quickly. Out of position, the pack's a little bit too far back. Actually did a lot of damage, and the pack is firing still. He should retreat that one. The other Hellcat isn't actually joining the fight here. Oh, gets wiped. The other Hellcat didn't join the fight. Bit of a misplay there by Palicious on the left side, though. Pretty big engagement. Actually drops a bar. Huge blow now. Grenadiers with a bar and Vet 2.
Pretty
very, very good, yeah.
Sniper, after walking away here from Perlicious, we're rotating and
Sticky's
they're going to take it out.
The Hellcat will get taken out. Doesn't actually hit the Stew, and the pack won't penetrate, but it will eventually. Sniper gets destroyed by the counter snipe of Woggy. The Stew does fall, but so many squads have been destroyed. This other one as well will walk away, but loses a rifleman squad. Both of his Hellcats. Crocodile not quite within time. The Crocodile wasn't there to wipe out the pack. Sniper as well can get wiped too if he goes for the chase, but denying the pack would be a good move. Sniper's still there, and the pack doing so much damage. It's really good pack control.
Work.
I think he wants to wipe the sniper, and probably he will find it.
Yeah, he will find it. It's actually going to retreat. Allied War Machine does go down here. Yes, I know what that's called now. Fantastic.
Nice. Well
Crocodile's
done.
Getting shot very, very low just outside the pack's firing arc. Oh!
Gets destroyed, but another one has been called in. But that's 200 munitions a pop. So that's a lot of munitions down the drain. If he was infantry again, the off-map arty would be very powerful. Sticky Bomb's completed. Actually didn't have stickies. So I think there's just not enough squads here now for Palicious. He's thrown away so much, especially all of the fuel. Bear in mind, though, call-ons don't actually cost fuel in this. So not having any fuel won't delay his Calliope or Pershing. Another Crocodile on the field, the one that he got for free. We'll go for the wipe on the pack. The Shreks now are going to be pretty powerful as well. If he can wipe
round number two.
Yeah, gets the wipe.
That's important.
And let's see if he recaptures. He can't really destroy. He doesn't have any, like, explosives, which he'll need. And the med bunker still going strong. Shreks, got to be careful. Flamers and the Crocodile. Really strong against those. Sniper as well from Palicious will decrew the MG. And Rifleman still hammering down the middle. Vet 2 on the Rifleman. Veterancy for Americans, so powerful in Co 1. Much more powerful than Co 2, but also quite hard to obtain because, again, you don't get it from damages done by kills. Recruise the pack, and you can use that to take out the bunker. And it will do it pretty quickly as well.
Probably should back up that one as well there. The Faust does, of course, come out from those Volscrens. It wasn't quite enough to take out the Crocodile, but he's got to be careful.
Yeah, the Faust aren't very powerful.
Yeah.
They're not very good, but it is a last-ditch effort. It's sort of a way, if you combo it up with other AT, you can secure a kill. It's more of an early-game deterrent to Greyhounds. Double snipe. Pretty powerful.
They're doing work. They really are. They're shredding down the Rifleman. I'm loving the Co-1 snipers.
Yeah, they're deadly. But play it enough and you'll hate the Co-1 snipers.
Oh, will I really?
The thing is with the packs, is it's like Co-2, where if you only have one member, they get wiped.
Yeah.
So the pack is hard to use because two snipers can insta-decrew.
So you really have support with Riflemen and stuff like that.
Yeah.
To make sure it doesn't get caught out of position.
Not having six-man squads makes it harder to use packs.
What? I want my six-man squads.
Yeah.
Only way to play.
This may just come down to a battle of the VPs. It still is a lot in the favor of Palicious, but I think the snipers are giving so much map control to Woogie. It's Woogie, yeah, not Woogle. And really, the Calliope...
Oh, it's Woogie, is it? Okay.
It's Woogie. It's an I. The Calliope may change the game, because the Calliopes can wipe the snipers. If you hit and they do hit pretty easily because they're really big explosive shells. So they can wipe easy. So the Calliope is going to be excellent late game, but it might be a little bit too late.
Yeah, especially given...
Sniper's firing. Nope.
Oh, no kind of sniper going out there. It does re-cloak. Imagine to see, Pillar just really did throw away the fuel advantage with both of those M18s going down. Sniper war.
See, notice only one sniper or Woogie fight on the pack.
Yeah.
And the reason why is so the other sniper can wait.
Yeah,
so it was kind of baiting out the counter sniper, if it makes sense.
Yeah.
Also,
we're going for the one for one.
Vet one on the sniper for Delicious. I don't actually know what it does, to be honest. It's been a while. I forget the veterancy factors. Tiger on the field. That is the call on Tiger's. Very, very powerful. Very hard to deal with. And the problem this is now for Delicious is the Calliopes are going to be harder to use. It may be more appealing going for the Pershing. But the Pershings aren't exactly fantastic against the Tigers. The Pershings are kind of like the old IS-2s. Their anti-infantry damage is just insane, but they're not fantastic against, like, vehicles. It's pretty even, but the Tiger's generally just a bit better overall. Sniper's looking for the counter-snipe here, and... gotta be careful. Oh, he gets it! Gets the counter-snipe. Yeah, it loses that one. A vet one as well. Not exactly ideal. I know the Vermax snipers are vet 3. They get, like, faster rate of fire. That was a Tiger blow up. Yeah, doing pretty good damage. Oh, Vet 2 Sniper as well. And, yeah, I think they get more range at Vet 3. So it's pretty powerful. As a general rule, pretty much everything Vet-wise is better for American, but it's harder to get. Where Vermark, you can buy it, so therefore it's not as strong overall.
Yeah.
Pack doing some actually okay damage.
That's and... working as the Tiger there. Has some nice penetration. Sniper hasn't been revealed yet.
Yeah, the MP40s may reveal it, though. Sniper's not around for Woogie. Tiger can take out the Sherman pretty easily, especially if he combos up with a Shrek. And really, this is the problem, is throwing away those two M18s. There's just no way to deal. Yeah, apart from the pack, which is so iffy because of the snipers. That's really it. Pershing with the field repair may work, though. Well, gets the damage and crit.
The pack is just shooting for days, but the snipers do move in. I think they managed to get the decor. Yeah, they got the decor on the pack, so that was well baited from Wii. This is fantastic play.
Yeah.
It really is. Really high tier.
Definitely, yeah. Indeed. That's actually a Pioneer squad. You can get repair bunkers, by the way.
Cool.
Yeah, you put a bunker and then you upgrade it. You're either an MG, a med bunker, or a repair bunker. Repair bunkers generally aren't used that much, but they are pretty strong if you want to have repairs.
Cool. So we need five, don't we? Five command points to get the Calliopes on the
boat. Ooh, he gets this kind of snipe, though. Nice work from Pelicious. And also, snipers give you a lot of vet. So vet 3 will be unlocked pretty soon, and that is a really nice power spike there. Tiger can actually destroy the pack 40 on the ground if he goes for it now. It would be a pretty good move. Also, I'm pretty sure packs are better than the whatever AT guns Americans get, and they can't get them because it's tier 3, not tier 2. Yeah, he's going to tier 4.
Yeah.
So he doesn't have AT guns, which is a bit of a problem.
The blow, yeah, especially after using both of those M18s. Could two M18s kind of deal with the Tiger?
Look, maybe. I mean, probably not unless they flank.
Yeah.
They're not very good. They're sort of like the M10s on KOTU.
Ah, okay, fair enough.
They're not Jacksons by any means.
Not by any means.
Yeah, they're not so much. Their power is their speed.
Yeah.
They have really good damage and penetration, but they're very weak. So, like, they probably can, but realistically, the Shreks and the packs will prevent that from happening. Losing the pack 40-38 would be a huge blow, and it gets destroyed. How can Pelicious deal with the Tiger without the pack? He's going to have to go Pershing.
That's going to be hard, He has
killed one of the snipers, which will make the Tiger may wipe the sniper. No, not quite. You also re-cloak faster if you're in cover than if you're out in the open.
Going for the machine flank from the little things right around the outside, from the pushing in on the side. Looking for some damage and looking for that, a bit of a, I guess, a flank on some of the infantry here. Doesn't really have any way of dealing with the Tiger, though, so...
Yeah, it's
surprising.
It's gonna be a bit of a problem
here. I think
he
needs the VPs.
I mean, the Crocodile can take a fair bit of punishment, though, from the Tiger. And Sniper does kill some models here, and Crocodile will have to back away from this one. Yeah, I don't know what he's doing, to be honest. He may even lose this rifle. Tiger's gonna have some nice damage, and will force the retreat, but he may lose that one. Tight rotation on the Tiger may be the saving grace for that rifle squad. I think he was looking for a counter snipe.
He was looking for the baby.
There we go.
The Pershing.
That's the Pershing. He may be looking for a sticky. Stickies are very powerful and will cause a engine critical. Pershing has hit the field now. Where are the packs and a crocodile as well? It's very, very low. Tiger firing at the crocodile and not the Pershing here. Getting very, very low. He should back this one away. No, he's popping Allied War Machine. He can afford it. He can afford it. Or maybe field repairs.
Maybe he's holding onto it.
His main decide the game
it's
here.
Pretty intense.
Pyro did get wide damage destroyed engine. If he pops it now, that would be an excellent move. Pershing is being ignored right now.
Main gun destroyed, engine destroyed, the machine is that's a sticky.
That's a sticky as well. Gets the damage into crit. Crocodile is out of control. I think he's waiting for the field repair. Pershing though, gotta be careful. Shrek's doing some good damage as well. Where are the packs? One up here.
There's only one left, I think. I don't know if there's another one.
This is going to be a battle of supporting AT. Rifle have a very low cooldown on the Stickies, and Pershing doing some really nice damage and really nice kiting as well. Stickies may get destroyed and immobilized. This Tiger bit of trouble here, but Pershing not exactly out of scot-free either. Shrek doing some good damage too. This could go either way. The Calliope going to have to back away from this one, I think, and wait for some more Stickies because the Tiger... Oh, it's so close. One more shot will turn it. Allied War Machine. That's what we want to see, ladies and gentlemen. Gets the Tiger, but he gets his Pershing
well
back.
Well played there from Felicious.
Yeah.
That was fantastic.
Nice.
I'm a convert.
Are you?
I'm a convert, man. This game is awesome.
See, I think what would have been nice as well was field repair. The reason being you lose your vet, and you don't want to lose vet. Vet's a big deal. And yeah, Pershings, they're ridiculous against infantry. They're so powerful.
So all of a sudden,
they were white.
Yeah, Polisius, he's in a great position. Ooh. Because the Tiger's gone down. He's got a full health
Pershing
on the field.
And he's floating fuel as well, so he can spam Shermans if he so desires.
Fantastic. Because is it just manpower to call in the Pershing?
Yeah.
Pershing.
Manpower. So the Tiger and Pershing once again, I think going for some Shermans or even M18s for the supporting AT. It's going to be the problem here. Actually, forces these snipers. Did miss though. Again, retreating targets can't quite hit. Woogie in a bit of trouble blocking off the retreat path on the sniper. Nice play here. Tiger joining the fight and a nade going in. Ooh, doing a fair bit of damage there. Sniper actually running in as well. Gotta be careful. But the snipers have retreated from Woogie, so they have a lot more free reign. Pershing though, again, can't exactly 1v1 the Tiger unless he has some stickies. Vet 3 on the sniper, and the Shrek's taking it down very, very low. The Pershing playing a risky game. What is he doing? He needs to back away. He's baiting for a mine.
He's baiting into the mine. The Pershing's doing a great job there, but he has to keep moving. He's kind of juking out on the fence at the moment. The Tiger.
Oh, nice.
Where's the rotation going to come from? It might come in the right direction here. How close to the garrison is the Tiger going to walk?
Oh, and
there's
the
M18. In the background there. It is quite low, though. I think it took some damage from the Shrek. The Tiger's going to dodge the mine. Maybe. Yes? No?
Look, if he hits a mine, the M18 will circle straight. Yeah. Nice, he's juking around the garrison.
Oh wow, the plays here from Pershing.
And now the Tiger is caught. I think he's actually going for the M18 though. He may find it. One shot, we'll take it out if he gets within range.
No.
Pershing though, but the mine though will detonate if the Tiger fires on it. He's trying to juke around the garrison, but the Pershing isn't exactly fast. Not like an iron, the mine blew up.
The mine detonated.
Oh no, losing the Pershing is a big blow, but bear in mind, like, losing the tanks isn't as big as a deal of Kotu. Again,
there's no fuel.
It's still 800 manpower is a pretty big cost, but I think that could definitely be microed better if the Pershing just ran away. Tiger on the field will do a lot of damage here, and really, one of the strengths of Vermark 2 is their veterancy, like, it stays over the new tank. So if he loses his Tiger, and if he has Vet 3, the new Tiger will also be Vet 3.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
That's hell cool.
Yeah. So that's why late game is very strong for Vermark, is because, like, unit preservation isn't important. Again, American unit preservation more important because Vet is more powerful, but harder to obtain. M18, got to back away from this one. Tiger looking to find some blood, and we'll find it. Main gun destroyed. And that is the Blitzkrieg as well. We'll give him extra movement speed and rate of fire. M18, what are you doing? I think he was in ambush mode, the stealth. Sticky actually will immobilize it.
The Tiger.
What?
Blitzkrieg's not going to help you with that.
Stickies are a pretty big deal. Bear in mind, Vet 2 gives Rifleman extra sticky range. Vet 3 gives them extra damage, which affects Stickies as well. That Tiger will get taken out by the Pershing once it hits the field.
The tank depot is pretty low.
It's not really a huge deal, though. I don't think the tank depot is important, and I think probably AT guns would be a better investment rather than M18s. There is the Pershing going for the Tiger. Immobilized will get destroyed here. Rear armor will give 100% penetration, if I'm not mistaken, on the Pershing.
Probably do as well. Yeah, that's nice. Should probably finish off the tank depot though. He didn't actually finish it off. It would be nice to finish it off, surely. Yeah. I might not finish it.
And there we go.
Good job, Kirk.
Vet one. Yeah.
Nice.
Vet one. I think it's only speed again though. I'm pretty sure it's like speed, accuracy, yeah, damage. I think it's 1.25 speed, 1.25 accuracy, 1.5 damage.
Okay.
I think, but yeah, I'm probably incorrect. I'm probably really incorrect. But
with that being said, look at the VPs. I mean, they're really, really even, but all three are being held by
It's the right stats though. Pretty much everything American, all these tanks, is speed, accuracy, damage.
Ah.
I could also be wrong in the order. It might be like damage accuracy, but I'm pretty sure it is accuracy damage. Vet 2, Vet 3. And look, these snipers continuing to go to town. It has actually been rebuilt. And I think the problem, not a lot of riflemen and not a whole bunch of vet. Pershing, gotta be very careful because the packs and the Shrek's still doing good damage. Sniper playing it risky here is Vet 3. Don't want to lose that one. Looking kind of sniper, will he find it? Yes, gets one of them. One. Nice work.
But Grenadiers. Can I get return sniped? No,
nah, not in time. Grenadiers aren't very good like against snipers, as you would see from riflemen with the bars. So, yeah, I think that's the main thing, is that snipers, like, you think that, oh, it's really out of position, but, like, not really. Because of the cloak and because of the extra, like, armor and the received accuracy and the health and stuff. Also, I think they get some sort of armor. Yeah. Maybe it's the Wehrmacht snipers. I probably should have read the stats before passing this, but whatever. Who cares? So, I think it may be the battle of the Tiger versus the Pershing. I mean, a lot of munitions for Blitzkrieg, which definitely helps. Infantry sprint, tanks move faster, and they fire more frequently. So it does give a pretty big edge. And the problem here for the map is there's just no munitions. There's no field repair for the Pershing.
Really needs to cap some of this map back, and that's where his infantry disadvantage does come in. He'd lose a fair few squads, and that has definitely been affecting it. So many Tigers and Pershings and all sorts of stuff.
Yeah.
So I love it.
Pretty nuts.
Tigers moving in now. Pershing, I think, was repaired.
Ooh, sniper.
Snipe.
Doesn't quite get caught. I think one thing I would love to see from Woogie is more mines. I mean, considering he's floating 500 munitions,
yeah,
I would love to see more mines.
700 fuel.
Yeah. I mean, Blitzkrieg is probably the hardest faction to spend, a sub-commander to spend munitions on. Like, Terror and Defensive, you have a lot of really cool abilities. Where Blitzkrieg, you only really have Blitzkrieg. That's the MG, actually.
It was recaptured there.
I don't know if he'll walk away from it, though. Tiger can wipe it pretty hard. Doesn't quite hit the target. Oh, it gets sticky as well. He lands a sticky. Again, the Vet 2 gives more range. So crucial. How effective will it be? Doesn't actually get any engine crits. They're doing some pretty good damage. And I think one thing that I really like about Ko 1 is stickies are fun. AT grenades in Ko 2 are boring. They're really easy to land because of URA and the fact that the animation will always follow through. Yeah. With stickies, they don't always, like, finish. But they're not very rewarding. You get an AT grenade, it doesn't always penetrate. And if it does, it's not as punishing. There's no destroyed engine crit. Well, it's really small. There's no immobilized. So it's low risk, low reward. Where stickies are high risk, high reward. Well, not so much reward, but, like, a risk. But it's harder to land. May even wipe that one as well. Not quite.
So
normally, yeah, you have to actually flank with riflemen. You have to have one squad behind, one squad in front, and, like, box them in to stickies. When you have Vet 2, it helps a lot, and it's kind of only because the Tiger is slow as absolute hell. So it is a bit easier to land them. Sniper is still there. Tiger, he may miss and hit the Sniper if he's unlucky.
It's the MG for now. I haven't looked at the sticky, don't quite find it though. Pershing is moving in from the side. Might not be enough though.
There's a pack
there, that's not good.
Flamer there, and the Rifleman can decrit that. There's a Blitzkrieg for the disengage. Pershing going in deep, but will actually get the decree with the flamer. He's sticky as well. Will get a critical, I would say. Damaged engine, but the Pershing is just too low and will have to retreat.
Yeah, it's probably going to be enough, though. I mean, he didn't wipe the pack, and that's definitely going to be nice. And it'll have to take a little bit of map control out at this point.
Oh, but rear armor. He may get an immobilized. Vet 2 giving extra armor on the Tiger. No, and doesn't get the chance there. Gotta be careful, there's a Shrek and a Panzerfaust available. The Pershing really needs to be more careful. Didn't quite penetrate though. The Pershing hasn't quite annihilated these Grenadiers yet. May do so soon. Actually not having the best time.
Nah, it's not really.
Against the infantry. Normally Pershings are a bit more deadly than that. Yeah, I mean, if he loses this Pershing, this is probably game over. His riflemen are just so outmatched.
Don't really have anything to hold it off with. The rifleman squad there a little bit too low. Oh, the Faust got cancelled. Nice. You got the suppression.
Yeah, nice suppression.
Yeah.
Maybe it was range. I don't actually know, but look. Oh, manpower blitz. Check this out. 175 munitions. Yeah. You get 900 manpower, but then your rate is reduced. So it's really good for calling
a
tiger.
You can call in something, yeah.
Yeah, and you can actually call in... Oh, no, you can't. Only one tiger.
Yeah, one tiger at once.
Wow.
So you could go for a stew, I guess. Or I guess you just need the more manpower, but maybe more squads. I mean, he just has to hold out at this point.
Elite tanks. Vet 3 tanks. Yeah, so... Not taking up. I think, like, maybe even, like, a panther would be nice. Just to ensure that he takes out the Pershing. But, like, 120 manpower, not really a lot in the bank, but having the ability to spam out the Blitzkrieg will definitely help.
Felicius. It's very, very low on these VPs. Ooh. Gotta be careful with that rifleman. So
yeah, snipers. If he lucks out, not quite.
Right.
Both of them missed. Look. Low VPs here. There's only 93.
He needs to make something happen.
The M18... He has a bit of a window now because there isn't the destroyed engine. Damaged engine. And there's only a pack in the base. So the Shrek, though, is actually doing really good damage. You can also get double Shreks, I'm pretty sure, on Grenz. I know you can on what are they called? Stum something. Did he lose his MG? Yeah, he did.
Yeah, he did.
I'm
losing that to the sniper.
Stum Troopers.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, Stum Troopers are cool. They're cloak and they move while cloak with two Shreks. So you can, like, stealth around and ambush rear armor with two Shreks. They're pretty deadly, but they're not very good in infantry combat.
Here comes the line.
M18 dropping incredibly fast here. There is a Blitzkrieg for disengage. We'll prevent the Stormstrike pack moving as well. The pack also sprints Pershing. He's in very deep, and the pack blocks him off. Shrek gets a rear armor penetration. It's a Vet 3, but there is a Sherman 2. Will help out in this engagement here. Pack, gotta be careful of the Flamers. Tiger is Vet 3 and will be absolutely powerful. Pershing does disengage, but a Sherman, he's in far too deep and will get taken out. Probably if the Tiger lands one more shot. Felicius is calling the GG. Riflemen are moving in, and that is game over. Woogie claims this one.
Well played. That was a really, really cool game. Felicius definitely had the early game advantage and then just got shoved back.
I mean, that often happens, though. Like, that is, like, that's really the matchup.
Yeah.
But... Look, I think the delay in the Calliope was the problem. I think if the Calliopes came sooner, before the Tiger hit the field, the Calliopes would have wiped the snipers. They would have wiped the packs.
Yeah.
It would have been great. Or I would have also added a mention. I would have liked to see Infantry Company. You don't have that late game Pershing, but the Pershing, like, isn't that fantastic as you did see. Like, they're good against Tigers, kind of, but not when there's so much supporting AT. It was Pershing versus Tiger... Plus Shrek,
pack.
Plus pack.
Yeah.
Where, I mean, all there was for Pelicius was the M18s that just died straight away and stickies that didn't always land. So I think also maybe going for tier 3, the AT gun, but the problem was the snipers. And so you have to sort of wipe the snipers with the Calliopes or with some sort of flank, and the snipers really control the matchup because they limit your options. You can't really go the AT guns when there's that many snipers.
Supporting weapons are a lot harder.
Yeah, exactly. So, I'm no pro by any means, but I just think that if the Calliopes came out sooner, we would have been fine, and the howitzers are nice against snipers. You build the howitzer, they cost fuel, though.
Yep.
But you can, like, put a howitzer in your base, and it blows up snipers. There's no smoke, it's on map, but there is a really loud noise, so you hear it coming, but it is good against... the campy playstyle. But anyway, that'll wrap this game up. Thank you for watching. Really, generals, gentlemen, we do a lot of Co 2, but not really much Co 1. We'll probably change that if there's good replays. So thanks for watching. Be sure to subscribe if you want to see more Company of Heroes action. Catch you later.
Cheers.